If you're not excited as a scientist, a technologist, anybody around this time, you know, I think maybe there's something a little bit wrong. Hi, I'm Darío Gil, and I am the director of IBM Research. My original background is in the field of semiconductors and nanotechnologies. And then hopefully everybody knows I'm very passionate about quantum too. I really believe this is the most exciting time in computing, probably since the 1940s. And I go back all the way back to that because that's when the first programmable computers were invented. That's when the transistor was invented. So there was just so much creativity at that time that built the edifice of building modern day IT. And now in this decade, we are seeing this convergence of scaling the limits of semiconductors, the limits of AI, quantum computing coming to bear, all of these things working with each other. So I think we're super lucky to be living in this time. The role of research in this famously dynamic industry, right, where so much changes, is to always have both the headlights and the talent model that allows us to continuously create what's next in this fantastic category of computing. I get to spend a lot of time with researchers and with the engineers and the designers that work in a wide variety of disciplines, meaning everything from advanced semiconductors to artificial intelligence to quantum computing to cryptography and you name it. So I find fascinating the diverse disciplines. I'm always learning, I'm always challenged, and you're meeting a wide variety of people. I like that I can walk down the hall and see people building materials and doing depositions of semiconductors and physical sciences, and other people are theoreticians or writing code or the designers. And that for me brings me energy, and I like that diversity. I also like a lot the intersection between this world and the world of business, right? Is technology, but for what purpose? What problem are we solving on behalf of our clients and the ecosystems, also with government? I like that intersection very, very much as well. AI occupies so much of my time, particularly over the last few years. I mean, everybody knows just how exciting the area and how fast changing it is. So in the research division, we build the granite models, the foundation models that we use across the company, right, to do generative AI. I've been in IBM 21 years, but the question remains the same. Why stay, right? Why have I stayed around that? In my field, like, you could go to a fantastic laboratories that they only work on one field. Like, for example, they only do computer science or they only do AI. I think IBM is incredibly special in that you can have many careers within the same company. No one has ever told me, oh, you cannot do that, or like, you have to stay in this bucket and you cannot move from this bucket. If you're interested and passionate and you're willing to take risk and learn and work hard around that, you can move from area to area. And my experience, the reason I've stayed is because I've gotten to do so, 21 years, but many, many jobs, many different kinds of things. And I've loved that. That's number one. I think the second is without a doubt because of my colleagues. I have had so many great people that I've worked with that I admire. I mean, some people were idols of mine, right? In terms, before I came here to the research division, that I so greatly admired. And I felt it was very fortunate that I could work with people like that. Talent is distributed in every geography, in every background. Once you see also more role models, more examples of people participating in that, I think it opens the eyes of others, and you see yourself in them, and you can see it more reflected. And then it's a little bit easier, right, to take the next steps in that direction, right? And that has happened in the fields, right? In fields in engineering and so on. It used to be an all-male endeavor almost, much more homogeneous. And when I go and see, my oldest daughter is studying computer science, and I remember what things would look like. And when I look at, and I go visit the university now, and I see 50-50, right, male-female ratios and the diversity around, there's been so much improvement from that perspective, but we still have so much room to go. I mean, in Hispanics as an example, I think representation at the level of in science and technology or in STEM fields, we have ways to go, and we still have a lot of work to do on that front. That's one of the reasons why I also got interested and involved in public policy and science and technology matters around that. Because if you look at things like the National Science Foundation and others, is that that's That's how we invest, right? In developing more talent and more capacity in the nation. We're fortunate to work in the field that we work in, right? This category of computing and information technology is touching every facet of society.